Good day, everyone. Look at the pictures and read the title. What is the text about? In order to get more information, let's read the text. The Boat Schools of Bangladesh. Where is your school? On a quiet street? On a busy road? Next to a beautiful park? Well, imagine going to school on a boat. In Chalanbil, Bangladesh, where there are huge floods every year, this is a reality for many students. Each small wooden boat has got a classroom and there are desks and chairs for 30 children inside. There is even a blackboard and a computer with internet. The schools are very simple, but they have all the essential equipment, including a library with lots of books. The boat schools are very important because when there are floods, they are the only schools around. For the children of Chalanbil, they are not just boats. They are a way to change their lives. The Vitra Telephone Plant School. Can you think of a school without classrooms? In the Vitra Telephone Plant School in Sweden, you can. This school is one big open space full of bright colors and different areas. One area is for study, another for doing experiments, a third for relaxation. When students work in a group, they gather around a large table to use a computer. When they work by themselves, they can use their laptops wherever they are. Why laptops? Because in this school, students do everything electronically. Now it's time to look at the translations of today's new words. Your first task will be to decide, are these sentences true, false, or doesn't say? In your second task, I want you to compare these two schools. The third task tells you to listen and identify which picture would describe it. My classroom has got desks and chairs. For all the students, there is a blackboard, but there is not a television or projector. There are not posters on the wall, and there is not a bookcase. All our books are in the school library. In the task number 4, I would like you to write about your school and classroom, as in this example. That is all for today. See you soon.